an African country situated in the Gulf of Guinea, is harboring a vast road construction program. President Paul Biya has planted an infrastructural development program consisting of 51 road access and engineering road infrastructures. We invite you to follow us into its discoveries.
So hush, little baby, don't you cry. No need of crying. One of these mornings.
The project for the construction of the Sang-Malima-Weso transborder road includes the tarring of about 700 kilometers between Sang-Malima in Cameroon and Weso in Congo. This with the objective of linking both countries to facilitate trade between them. On the Cameroonian side, a distance of 322 kilometers long is under construction. The stretch from Sang-Malima to Bikola was at 62% executed by May 2020, with several fallouts as benefits to the population. Meantime, the Bikola-Jum lot, 38 kilometers long, was at 60% done by May 2020. 221 direct jobs created, with 121 of these jobs reserved for locals, amongst other benefits.
That morning, until that morning, there is nothing gonna harm you.
Despite challenges like the non-liberation of sidewalks, the construction company and its control mission expressed optimism to complete the project on the scheduled deadline.
The main problems are the expropriation and to pay the indemnity for the peoples, and the obstacles in the on the roads.
This pygmy settlement is a vivid illustration of a non-liberation of sidewalks. During a visit to the site by the supervisory authority, the pygmies gave their conditions prior to their displacement. In regard to their human and minority rights, the Minister of Public Works instructed the construction company to treat their request with urgency. Construction works had been completed on the 95 kilometers long Jum Mintum stretch that yielded 180 direct jobs. 80 of these jobs reserved for the local population. 3 multifunctional centers for women and youths, 60 kilometers long communal roads, 2 motor parks, 5 constructed schools, 2 communal radios, 60 boreholes, amongst others. The project has boosted agro-pastoral production in the area, reduced poverty and rural exodus.
La route fait partie des idées premières ou alors des idées incitatrices qui nous ont conduit à créer l'entreprise.
The road constitutes one of the major factors that led to the establishment of this project. It's often said that where the road passes, development follows. With this road, we can easily sell all our farm produce. We are a complex that deals in agriculture, animal rearing, and so on. Without a road, we can't sell our produce. The road links Yaoundé to Congo, and you know, the Congolese constitute a huge market. The south region of Cameroon, being very fertile and conducive in terms of agriculture, can only be a greenery that would help feed the population of our neighboring countries.
The other two lots, Mintum Lele, 67.5 kilometers long, and Lele Ntambalam, 53 kilometers long, were attributed to two Chinese companies, Sino Hydro and Yangang Construction Limited. Both companies recorded a 75.7% execution rate by the month of May 2020. However, work in the five lots on the Cameroonian side of the Sang-Malima-Weso Transborder Road Construction Project is closely supervised by the authority in charge. Despite minute-by-minute report, constant work site visits are undertaken.
My assessment is that the works are going on very well. We visited some section where the work was not going on for the past 6 months. Let's say clearly, Sang-Malima-Bikula. You see with me that the work has started, which is very good for us. Secondly, we have been discussing with our partners on how to master the cost of the road construction. We agree with the control mission that we should really put emphasis on what we intend to construct as road. You have a difference between communal road, regional road, national road, or a corridor. So we should really focus our attention in order to reduce the cost by making our people to adjust themselves in what we are looking for, not in what they are intend to do for us. Some economy has been made already on the section Jumlah Minto, 740 million. We will use those economies in order to construct some social amenity to the people or to construct secondary routes.
While waiting for its completion, trucks are already plying the road.
You know that we truck drivers suffer a lot. We feed poorly. We sleep almost everywhere in very bad conditions.
Upon completion, the Cameroonian side will be linked to the Congolese side that had already been inaugurated on May 6, 2020 by the Congolese President Denis Sassou Nguesso. This for the dream of both presidents to be realized.
There is nothing thought of on you.
To ameliorate transport and security on the National Highway No. 4, the government of Cameroon has engaged the rehabilitation of the Yaoundé Bafoussam Babadjo Bamenda Road. The works are partitioned into five lots. The lot from Yaoundé, Ebebda and Kalong, 63.75 kilometers long, was at 70% executed in the month of May 2020. Same assessment was made at same period concerning the stretch from Kalong to Tonga, 67 kilometers long.
There is nothing gonna hold.
Since the substratum of the road is of very fine material, the place for geogrill is very important for our road. And the geogrill will somehow is not a complete 100% stoppage of cracking. A crack that could have occurred in 3 years with the presence of geogrill, it can project it to 12 years. So at least that will help to increase the lifespan of our road.
Execution rate was still at 20.3% for the Tonga Bafoussam and Bafoussam Babadjo lots in the month of May 2020. But construction works across the West Regional Capital, Bafoussam, had attained 84% at same period. This gradually giving the city a new facelift. A different story for the Babadjo Bamenda lot that had been interrupted due to the socio-political crisis in the northwest and southwest regions of the country. Works on that stretch, however, resumed by the beginning of the year 2020. Several opportunities have been generated by the construction project on the Yaoundé-Bafoussam-Babadjo-Bamenda Road Rehabilitation Project.
There is nothing gonna harm you. No, 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 no.
Nurturing his dream of rendering Cameroon a road network hub, President Paul Biya also envisaged projects that facilitate links with neighboring countries. This, amongst others, includes the east entrance into the economic and port city of Douala. A 9 kilometers, 2-by-3-lane road is under construction. This to end the dreaded long-hours traffic jams that were observed at that entrance. Resolving the challenging Mbe Clift in the Adamawa region and easing transportation, an 89 kilometers long road has been constructed between Goundéri and Mbéri. Also between Mbéri and Garoua, maintenance works are being done to ensure its fluidity and increase its lifespan. Beyond the north region, rehabilitation works are underway on the Marwa-Mora Road, 62 kilometers long, recording a 67% execution rate by the month of May 2020. This thanks to the liberation of sidewalks and general bulldozing. Potholes and dust are disappearing gradually as the construction works advances. Emphasis here is also placed on the development of accompanying socio-economic infrastructures, illustrated here by this school with 2 classrooms constructed, a principal's office and a constructed fence. On a worksite visit on July 17, 2019, the supervisory authority expressed his dissatisfaction with the narrowness of the structure, warning against its non-reception if laid down norms were not respected. The Mora Dabanga Kuseri Road construction project, 205 kilometers long, is being executed by the engineering corps of the military. This is due to crisis-prone nature of the area that is frequently liable to Boko Haram attacks. Worksite bases have been mounted, one in Mora and the other in Waza. A quarry and a site for the construction of concrete culverts. In the month of May 2020, execution rate of the Mora Dabanga Kuseri Road project was at 17% done. Over in the northwest region, the Bamenda Batibo Numba Road, 82 kilometers long, had already been completed, facilitating trade between neighboring Nigeria and Cameroon before the eruption of crisis in the northwest and southwest regions in 2016. The socio-economic impact of this road and the numerous socio-economic fallout are greatly appreciated by the population.
The Wedekum municipality is essentially an oil production zone, palm oil production zone. And before that road was, that major road was opened, we used to have a lot of difficulties in selling the evacuating the oil from Wedekum. But since that road was created, it has been very marvelous. The people, the farmers are gaining a lot from it. The prices are there, the market is there, the Nigerians sometimes come to buy. It is going to give us a lot of economic advantages. We have been able to get sheds constructed in the market. We are going to get, there are so many people, so many farmers are increasing the size of their farms so that they can produce more food, because indeed the food that they produce every day is being bought within the twinkle of an eye.
The roads have really helped me. I'm taking care of my family. I've sent my sister in US just because of this road.
Now, we take 1 hour, 30 minutes from Wedekum to Bamenda. And also, we don't even stand on the road. The hills which were worrying us has been reduced by good routes, for that matter. This road has been constructed from Bamenda to Manfe to Ekok, has facilitated so many people. E.g., I myself as a trader who used to come here and suffer and buy oil and go back to my house in Bamenda. And then from now to Manfe, Ekok, it has facilitated everybody.
In the southwest region, the long-awaited dream of the Bacho-Akabwe-Manfe-Ekok road construction, 63 kilometers long, is now a reality. The road before the crisis had brought invisible socio-economic impact on the population of the entire region.
People come here, they don't have where to live. So we are putting up a guest project, a guest complex there for people to come, so that when they come, they can have where to lodge. We are very, very thankful to the New Deal government for everything, every effort that they have been doing to see that Konya subdivision moves on the rails of emergence. Above all, we want to thank His Excellency President Paul Biya for this very, very wonderful gift that has been given to the people of Konya. And we wish him God's wisdom, protection, and guidance.
The Kumba-Manfe Road, which has been the cry of the Manyuman for so many, many years, has finally come to pass. The road has brought so many good things to Manyu Division and to the Manyuman. Right now, the Manyuman can do business with any part of Cameroon very easily. You leave Manfe, within 2 hours you are in Kumba. You buy your things for your business, within the next 2 or 3 hours you are in Manfe. Those going to Nigeria through Manfe, you leave Kumba, within 3 hours you are at the borders to cross to Nigeria. You know, movement has become very, very fast, very easy. Business has become swift. The town is developing very fast. It's becoming a cosmopolitan and business town at the same time. Socially, we're having new faces every day. People just come to Manfe to discover Manfe. The touristic areas like the German Bridge, which I'm sure you've gone to see, and other nightclubs, the Esperosa and other places.
Numerous youths have harvested employment during and after the construction work.
As you can see, this is called V-Gota. It is being dug. It started by excavation. It is being dug by an excavator. So when the excavator is being dug and gone, we use our formwork. This is called the gabare. We use our formwork to come out with this V-Gota. It is to enable the water, that's our drainage, to pass through here without any difficulties. We have two types of gutters that we use. We have this big gutter and the U gutter. This big gutter, it contains the volume of water that passes around here. So the V gutters, if you can look around, there are other places that the volume of water is too high that this V gutter cannot contain. They will put but the U gutter. This is called the finishing stage. for the finishing stage. When we come again, maybe about tomorrow, we'll remove this formwork so that we can fill this gap, so that water will pass through. We'll fill this gap again with concrete. Yes, we'll remove this formwork, clean our portion, and prepare it. Tomorrow, we'll fill another concrete inside. Yes, so you can see this, the earthwork. So tomorrow, we'll come out with the reinforcement. Reinforcement rod, they are all there. We'll come and we'll put them. Yeah, this is it, all true. This work, I was recruited right from Basibo. This company started right from Basibo, where they took us, and we are now in Kumba, presently. So I was being recruited by a contractor called Mr. Anjay Christopher. But this one, it enabled us to get, at least, to be employed, self-employed. Yeah, that is, it helped us a lot to feed, maintain our family, come up with our body needs, and all the rest.
Development that attracted local elites who came back home to invest and also assisted in the upgrading of local road accesses like the Samson Georges Road in Manfi.
I am the custodian of the Mosjan Quarter, that is Samson Georges Street. And Samson Georges Street was been named after the most famous politician, Samson Georges, of blessed memory, that borders the market, the park. So being an economic operator too, we are trying to look our best. The road has changed us immensely. Before, madam, you could come to Manfi, you could find that when you leave from Manfi, people could identify you in Kuba with a mud or with a dust that applies you. But today, you can reach Kuba Douala without anybody even knowing from where you are coming from. So it has greatly, the road has been so much. We don't know how we can dance. If I could be dancing here now.